Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to IIC Press book release event. The title of today's book that is going to be inaugurated is Notes on the Brown-Dodds-Kellman Theorem, authored by Professor Sameer Chavan and Professor Gadadhar Mishra. To start the book release program, may I invite Professor Amrish Chakravarti, Chair, IIC Press, to deliver the welcome address.
Yeah, so good afternoon, everyone. And again, this is always a very happy occasion every time a new book is released. I was on the phone. Professor Kaushal is going to join in a couple of minutes. I think he's just delayed from the previous meeting. He will join in a minute. So I'll get started on that. So again, my pleasure to introduce IIC Press to those who are not familiar with IIC Press. IIC Press got started in 2008 under the directorship of Professor Balaram, with a mission to bring quality books at affordable prices for helping primarily Indian postgraduate education in science and engineering, but not, of course, limited to that. And it also, of course, was launched as part of the celebration of the centenary year of the IISc. IISc Press has been, apart from publishing on its own, publishing books also with a number of co-publishing partners. The two co-publishing partners being World Scientific Publishing Company, and that has started from 2008. And we also have an agreement with Cambridge University Press, the world's oldest publisher and second largest university press, where we had an agreement that is going on from 2013. So we have therefore multiple ways of publishing books on our own and through our co-publishers in order to extend our base beyond the boundaries of the country. We have a number of series, the IISc Centenary Lecture Series, IISc Research Monograph Series, IISc Lecture Notes Series, all with World Scientific Publishing. And then we also have the IISc Popular Science Series and Biographies and General Books. So, our press committee, which is always a great delight to work with, has Professor Deeptiman Sen, Professor Prabal Maiti, and Professor S.P. Arun, along with me, and of course, Professor Kaushal Varma, ex-officio from the Office of Communications. Ably supported earlier by Ms. Kavita, and now by Ms. Dr. Bitasta. So we have been publishing various books in each of these series. For example, in Centenary Lecture Series, we had Trends in Chemistry of Materials by Professor Sienna Rao, Science and Sustainable Food Security by Professor Swaminathan, and so on. In Research Monograph Series, we have various books, including Basic Control, Volume Finite Element Methods for Fluids and Solids by Professor Vola of University of Minnesota and others. In the Lecture Notes Series, we have Great Variety, Introduction to Algebraic Geometry and Commutative Algebra by Dilip P. Patil and Uwe Stork, and various others. Noise and Vibration Control by Professor M. L. Munjal, Game Theory and Mechanism Design by Professor Yadati Narahari, and so on. Under miscellaneous books, we have the very successful coffee table book called Secret Lives by Natasha Matre. Was a student at IISc when she actually had written this book. And then we have a whole variety of books, including actually Arting Science, a book by Dr. Das, Bidasta Das herself. Autobiographies are included. The first director of IISc, Professor Maurice Travers's autobiography, was also published under this series. Under Popular Science Series, we have very popular Aero Basics by Professor S.P. Govindraju, Popular Problems and Puzzles in Mathematics by Professor A.K. Mallik, and so on. Under the IISc Press, Cambridge University Press Series, we have two volumes on Continuum Mechanics from Professor C.S. Jog. We have Ordinary Differential Equations by Professor A.K. Nandakumaran, and so on. So, and there is a whole variety of books that are right now in the pipeline. So it is my great pleasure to introduce IISc Press and, of course, invite all of you to publish books with us, either directly with us or with a co-publishing agreement. And we are actually right now speaking to another publisher to extend our global reach with our co-publishing agreements. So with that introduction, I would like to congratulate the authors of the new book and move back, give the podium back to Dr. Mitasa. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Chakravarti. Moving on with the program, may I now request Professor Kalyan Vidhan Sinha, Honorary Professor Jawaharlal Nehru Center for Advanced Scientific Research, Bangalore, to say a few words about the author and the book.
Am I visible?
Yes.
And audible as well, I hope?
Yes, audible also.
Thank you. Well, it gives me great pleasure in this occasion to say a few words. So I have known both the authors, Gadadhar Mishra and Samir Chavan, reasonably well, particularly Gadadhar, whom I first met in 1985 in Irvine, California, where I was visiting actually Barry Simon in Caltech. But on the side, I met Gadadhar, and I encouraged him to apply to Indian Statistical Institute at that time. And he indeed did and joined Indian Statistical Institute, Kolkata. However, I didn't really know him that well at that time. I came to know him well only when he moved to Bangalore sometime later. In fact, I remember whenever I used to visit Bangalore in the late 90s or early 2000s, and he introduced me to various culinary pleasures of Bangalore, and we used to hang around in Cunningham Road often with Gadadhar, visiting a few restaurants. And Samir Chavan, I came to know much later, again in a rather curious circumstances. I was participating and lecturing in a conference in NYSERD, Bhubaneswar, when a young mathematician, Dr. Rajiv Gupta, who I learned much later was a PhD student of Gadadhar in IISc, Indian Institute of Science, but at that time was a postdoctoral fellow with Samir Chavan in IIT Kanpur. And he asked me a question to help him solve. And I quickly saw that the problem was quite in my alley. So in a reasonable time, I could solve the problem. And then that led to a collaboration with Samir. And I had the privilege and good fortune of collaborating with both these authors. And I have also played a small role in getting this publication, which is going to be launched or released today. Now, this matter of the book or monograph, the BDF theory or the Brown-Douglas-Fillmore theory, which is the central theme of this monograph, was a pioneering result, paving the way for non-commutative topology. And Ron Douglas, the premier author, was the guru of Gadadhar, that is the PhD thesis advisor, in case some people do not know this. And in my view, I think this monograph should have been there about a decade earlier, but better late than never. And I look forward to similar monograph or monographs on the further development in these directions, particularly non-commutative topology and non-commutative geometry, in the hands of younger authors in these directions. I also had the good fortune, as I said, having collaborated with both the authors and coming to know them better in the course of these collaborations. And I wish both the authors well and very productive years in life, hopefully writing several such monographs in near future. So I'm very happy that this monograph is seeing the light of the day. Thank you all.
Thank you, Professor Sinha. for giving us this insight into the book and in the lives of the authors. May I now call upon the authors, Professor Gadadhar Mishra and Professor Sameer Chauhan, for the author's remarks.
Thank you. I'll let Sameer speak first, and then I'll perhaps just say a few words. Thank you very much.
Oh, can you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Okay, okay. Yeah. So I really do not know what to say, but let me thank everyone, including GM, and thanks KBS for nice words about the book, and I also thank ISC Press for this book and for publishing this book. And I think I would like to just stop here. I request GM to say something.
Okay. Yeah, thanks, Sameer. Well, without you, this book would have never seen the light of the day, because as you know, the notes are based on lectures given in 1992. And this has a lot to do with the history of ISI itself. I clearly remember hanging out in ISI, where there were basically a very narrow road going from Majestic to Kengeri, where if two BTS buses had to pass each other, one had to stop on the side, the other then went by, and so on. Now, of course, you will not believe what the ISI front looks like. We used to make fun of a river that was in front of the ISI campus, called Rishabhavati River. Again, nobody will recognize it anymore. So we were hanging out there, generally having a good time, drinking coffee. And the director of ISI, J.K. Ghosh, dropped in once and said, you know, what are you people doing here? At that time, no teaching program had started yet. We were thinking of beginning an undergraduate program.
Sorry, Professor Mishra, can I interrupt for a second? Just change your mic slightly so you can see the entire face of yours.
Okay. all right. Thank you. So, is it better now?
Yes, it's perfect. It's perfect now.
Right. So, anyway, I was saying that Professor J.K. Ghosh was the director at that time. We were out there in Kengeri, as it was, you know, we're not quite in Kengeri, but near there, in front of the Rishabhavati River. If you can find it, that would be quite an achievement, with all the flyovers, everything that's gone, perhaps. Generally, we used to hang out, have a good time, and Professor Ghosh came and said, well, look, what are you people up to? You should be doing something useful. No teaching program had started yet. We were trying to begin an undergraduate teaching program in mathematics. And like everything else in ISI, as opposed to other places, I think it took about a dozen years from the time that we conceived the program to the time that we were able to first begin teaching, I think in 2000. So, in the meantime, so the notes and the conference that I'm talking about is 1992 or so. It was at that time, there wasn't really any formal regular program at ISI. So at ISI Bangalore Center, that is. So Professor Ghosh said we should be doing something useful to occupy ourselves. And there are two things that we did, which is something that I'm proud of. With both, I was involved at that time. One was the Atiyah-Singer Index Theorem. There was a three-week-long workshop on that. And then there was the Brown-Douglas-Fillmore Theorem, along with two other topics, K-theory and index theory, Professor Sundar and Klaus Thompson were the other speakers. And we brought out some notes of those lectures, but those notes were lying around. And finally, when I met Samir about a decade ago or a little more than that. And then I kind of thought it would be a good idea to clean up these notes. And I proposed this to Samir, and poor fellow, he didn't know what he was getting into. And he had to do a lot of running around, break his head over, a lot of these details and things. I had some short notes prepared. They were around, but it was a long way from there to actually complete the book. And I must say, without someone like Samir, these notes were lying around for 25 years. They would have lied around for another 25 years without seeing the light of the day. So I must say, it's Samir who was responsible for actually making these notes possible. But I should say that I always hoped and thought that Professor Douglas will be around to see the book. Actually, when I had shared these notes with him, he did encourage me to actually make something formal out of it. But we have been running around, both he and me, and one never got around to doing it. And it is really sad that he isn't around. I was really very fond of him, and everything that I have learned as far as mathematics goes is of course from him. That goes without saying. But even as a human being, I'll just finish by saying one thing. When I was a PhD student at Stony Brook, obviously he was a very sought after mathematician. There was a rumor that he certainly was a very strong contender for a Fields Medal in 1978 or so. And very typical of him, he takes everything in his stride. And that's one thing we keep talking about Gita, we keep talking about how Western civilization perhaps often is behind us, they don't sort of understand these things. As far as Douglas is concerned, it's really quite amazing the way he would look at life, and in a kind of matter of fact way. I'll just give one example. Once, of course, I was always very proud of him. Anything that he did, I almost felt proud as if I have done it myself. So Brown Douglas Fillmore theory was certainly talked about a lot. And he was, as I said, a very strong contender for the Fields Medal. Around that time, he was in Oberwolfach, some conference or the other. And I sort of assumed that he will give a talk. And I'll sort of get to see what he says. And then when he returned from Germany, I asked him, what did you talk about? So he tells me, and here is Douglas, and he knows I kind of respect him both as a person, in mathematics and all that. So he tells me there were many good people at the conference. I did not get an opportunity to speak. Now, this is something that has stayed with me. There are, of course, several such incidents I can tell you about, but let me not take more of your time. Unbelievable sort of understanding of life and mathematics. I certainly think, it was really opportunity that I perhaps didn't even deserve. But as it turns out, until the very last year when he left us, we were together, we used to chat about all sorts of things. So I'm happy that this book has finally seen the light of the day, thanks to Samir. And I'm really, I wish Professor Douglas was around to see see this, but yeah, thank you very much. Yeah. I'll stop.
Thank you to the authors for giving us an insight into the process of writing a book. Now we come to the main part of today's event. May I now request Professor J.K. Ananthasuresh, Dean, Mechanical Science Division, to say a few words and formally inaugurate the book.
So before Professor Ananthasuresh opens his mouth, I just want to introduce him for a second. I think the world sort of many times comes around in a circle, and I'm seeing that happening here. That this IIC press committee was first chaired by Professor Anurag Kumar, and then later the mantle was passed on to Professor Ananthasuresh. He was the IIC press chair, and it's an absolute delight to now have him back as the Dean of Mechanical Sciences, giving his speech here. We are all indebted to you, Suresh, and it's great to have you back in this avatar.
Thank you, Amresh. Coming to IIC Press is always like coming to the family. So Kaushal and you, Amresh, and of course, Gadadhar. No, he was also in the IIC Press committee. Hi, Gadadhar. I didn't know that you retired. that seemed too soon. And of course, yeah, Deepthiman, right. And Prabal and Arun, and of course, Kavita and Bithasta. It's always like coming to OOC and IIC Press is like coming and meeting the family. And today I'm filling in for our director, Professor Angarajan. I think he would have been the right person to release a book that is a mathematics book. But I guess he's now suddenly something came up. He's having a meeting with the Prime Minister. So I'm filling in for him. And it's an absolute delight to release a book that probably a word of it I would not understand as a mechanical engineer. And thank you, Kaushal and Amresh, for giving me this opportunity. I don't know how to do release of a book virtually. But anyway, I think it's just a tradition that IIC Press has started, and we do that. We celebrate each and every single book that is published by IIC Press. And I think even during this online everything time also, it is being done. And that's very nice, Kaushal and Amresh, for doing this. And coming to the book, I first congratulate Professor Amir Chavan and Professor Gadadhar Mishra for the book. And some people call it old-fashioned because some people have asked us, you know, why do you still publish books in print form, right? But I think we are old-fashioned and we want to read books on paper and looking at it because they have its own place. And I think people have probably realized that during this pandemic time, when we all had online classes, I think majority of the instructors and students are looking forward to actually meeting face-to-face. I think that tells us that, you know, printed books have a place, and seeing everything in real is always a pleasure. And I was looking at this book to see what it's about. Not that I will understand, the Brown-Douglas-Wilmer theorem, but I found that there is already a link. Cambridge IIC Press series is available on Amazon. And when I looked at it, they have an e-text and a hardcover. And a hardcover book costs $76, and the e-text costs $72.61. I wonder why. Then they actually, they looked at it a little bit. They say if you buy e-text, you have the search feature. So that's the only thing I would say is in favor of e-copy of a book. You can search. But I was surprised to see another little blurb that was there in Amazon. It says that it can create flashcards instantly. So maybe if you buy the e-text of that book, all the flashcards, all the theorems and lemmas there will come out, and then you can use them to refer to. I don't know who would do that. But I think publishers have a way of marketing their book. That is really impressive. You know, they try to make money off the hard work of the authors all the time. And what IIC Press, I think we have talked at length, Gadadhar would remember and Kaushal Amresh would remember, how do we market IIC Press books, right? So that's why I think we are partnering with two, renowned publishers. But we have published our own books as well, and we have a way of selling them. OOC can sell these books, but marketing is where we need to rely on these publishers. And I'm sure this book will do well. And I, in fact, just looked through. I have a mathematics student at home. My son is studying at ISI, so I asked him about it, and he is not aware of the theorem, but he's looking forward to reading it. And with that, I congratulate Professor Gadadhar Mishra and Professor Amit Chavan once again. I want to say one thing about Gadadhar that I it's kind of relevant the way he talked about his advisor Ron Douglas. So we interacted quite a bit in the IIC Press committee, and once I think we both traveled together from New Delhi, and we had a long time chatting. And when we were coming back, you know, he said something that I can never forget, and it kind of resonates with what Gadadhar shared with us now about his advisor. In fact, Gadadhar asked this, you know, like a hypothetical question. We always reward people for doing that, doing this, and you know, some accomplishment. Is there no award for somebody being just a good human being? That's what Gadadhar asked me. That rings in my ears all the time. Not to say that, you know, Gadadhar is not accomplished. He's a very accomplished mathematician, very distinguished. But today in this small group, Gadadhar, I want to give you that award of being a good human being for what it is worth. Because several students of mathematics department have told me about you when you were chair or otherwise. They all, you know, delighted to talk with you. And how good you are to them, and I've seen it myself, experienced it. So really, congratulations! And I didn't know that you are retired, but I hope to see you sometime in person. So not is online.
Thank you.
And Bibi. I thank the IIC Press for giving me the opportunity to release this book. Thank you, Amresh.
May I request the authors to hold the book for display so that the audience can have a look?
Yes. Yes. Okay. Could you see?
Yes.
With us, yes. We need to take a photograph.
Yeah.
Okay. Like this. Or maybe like.
Yeah. So, I think that's it. Yeah.
Thank you.
So,
May I request Professor Kaushal Verma, Chair, Office of Communications, to deliver the formal vote of thanks.
Thanks, Vithasta. I have a few things to say here, so please bear with me. I'd like to begin by first thanking the authors, my young friend Samir from IIT Kanpur, and my senior colleague Gadadhar, who has just retired from the department. If I understand the tone of this book, they have gone back to something wonderful that was put together in the mid 70s, early 70s perhaps. And as it so happens, you know, mathematical ideas also tend to evolve over time. And what may happen is 30, 40 years down the line, people have essentially forgotten what the original starting point of all this was. And I think they have done a wonderful thing by actually going back to the original works, the original ideas, and put them together for the benefit of the modern reader. I believe retracing a historical path is not only paying homage to the original creators of this, but it also serves to provide a channel for the creation of new mathematics, of new ideas. I think this churning is very important. And I think they have done, in my opinion, a wonderful job and a very elegant job at that. So thank you very much, Samir and Gadadhar. This is so wonderful. I'd like to thank Anand Suresh deeply, because at the very last moment, a singularity arose in the program that, you know, we are going through today. And to make that a removable singularity, we had to resort to, you know, Suresh, and so nice of you to, you know, accept to be here. And your words have really made a good difference to the program. It's made my day and the event also. So thank you very much, Suresh. Always a pleasure to have you around. I must also thank the IIC Press Committee, chaired by Amaresh. It also has Deeptiman, Prabal and Arun. And I can say this for sure, you know, the IIC Press meetings are the most wonderful meetings that I go to in a given day. It's full of enthusiasm. There are lots of good ideas that come about, and things get done with, you know, lots of stories and jokes being told and so on and so forth. So these are meetings that I really look forward to. And I think I I think I'm fortunate to be a part of this committee. So thank you very much for being there. We have other plans which we sort of hope to take up in the future to ramp up the IIC Press activities. I would also like to thank all the Office of Communications staff. They are the real people who are behind the scenes, who do all the hard work. Somebody like me just gets to appear on a meeting and say a few words. That's nothing. That doesn't count as work. Conceiving a book and working through it right till the publication and the launch event is a very, very arduous task. Many things can go wrong, but they are the people who actually see to it that everything is in place and the final product is as pleasing as the contents. So a big thank you to everybody at the Office of Communications. This is an office that is run by each and every one of you. You are all stakeholders here. You are the ones who are actually doing the work. My designing team is not here, but I would like to extend a big round of thanks to both Jayesh and Charuta, who have been working with us at IIC Press for many years now. they have been such a wonderful source of support and encouragement to all the committee members. Last but not the least, we have a group of three or four printers that we always reach out to for all our production jobs. And they form a very, very crucial link in the entire chain, starting from the conception of a book right up to the release. So a big thank you to all of you. And it's always good to see everyone virtually. But as I keep telling Amresh, I think we should restart the physical in-person meetings. They have a charm that is irreplaceable. It's just like holding a print version of a book versus ordering an e-book. They just don't compare. You can of course catch up with your friends, have a cup of tea or coffee along with something else. Wish them the best and come home charged with a lot of positive energy. So thank you very much. I wish you all the very best.
Yeah, thank you,
Kaushal. Thank you, Kaushal. I, of course, you are being too humble. You are a major driving force behind all the Office of Communications activities. So I think you forgot to thank yourself. So allow me to do that on your behalf. So thank you, Kaushal. And about singularity, I think, it's great. I remember in Stephen Hawking's work, he tried to remove the singularity associated with the beginning of the universe and the beginning of time. So I think we are not at that proportion, but we are still thankful to our professor Anand Suresh for removing this relatively small singularity. So and finally, the number of rain checks that have come now in all the meetings, has brought rain instead. So we look forward to all the samosas as part of our meeting. So yes, it would be a welcome change. So thank you all very much.
Yeah, thank you.
Amresh, just one thing, I forgot to mention something about Professor Sinha. Professor Sinha, I just read about you and I had heard about you, and thanks for coming for today's event and speaking about the book and the illustrious authors. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. With that, we come to the end of today's program. Anyone wants to say anything? Last word? Okay.
No, thank you to everybody. Yeah.
Thanks. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you all.
Yeah.
Thank you all.
Yeah. We have to hope to have many more book releases and hopefully in person. Thank you so much.
Right. Yeah. Thanks. That's 51. Okay. Great. Thank you. Thank you all. Really, always a pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.